we have studied about the disease. Today we'll study what are the factors affecting the good health. You all know about health. So, a body is healthy when we are physically, mentally and socially fit. Physically, mentally and socially. Then only we have good health. And the factors which affect the good health, the main factors are the most important thing is the food, that is balanced diet. You all know that food is very essential for our body. It helps in the growth of the body and also for the proper functioning of the body. So the main factors which affect the good health is the food, and that food which is balanced. Means balanced diet means which consists of all the components like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. So all these things are very important for our good health. So most important thing is the food. Second is exercise. Exercise also keeps our body fit and healthy. This is the second factor. We should do the exercise daily, like yoga or any kind of sports we can play, or even meditation. So these are also the things which are important for good health. Yoga, sports, meditation and different types of exercise. The third one is rest and sleep. Because we all know that our body do a lot of work the whole day. For that we have to need rest. And rest can be taken only at night, because after sleeping or after taking rest, our body re-energizes for the next day. So rest and sleep is very essential part of the to maintain the good health. And fourth one is personal hygiene. Personal hygiene means taking care of our body, cleanliness of our body. In personal hygiene, many things can be included, like taking bath daily, wearing clean clothes, combing the hair, and many other things which keeps our body clean. That is called personal hygiene. And everybody should maintain the personal hygiene. Besides the personal hygiene, one more important thing is the community hygiene. Community hygiene means whenever our body surroundings are clean, then only we will be free from any kind of disease. If we are maintaining the personal hygiene, we are taking rest and sleep, we are doing exercise, we are taking proper food, but if our surrounding is not clean, means we can suffer from disease. Because if the garbages are lying outside, and in the garbage and the dirty things, the flies sit on, and whenever we that flies or the mosquitoes which breed outside, which comes to our home, and if the mosquito bites us or the house flies they sit on the food, and if we eat that food or water, drink that water or live in the dirty surrounding, means we will suffer from disease. So these are the five factors which affect the good health, that is food, balanced diet, exercise, rest and sleep, personal hygiene and community hygiene. That day I told you about the different types of disease. Some more kind of disease are there besides the acute and chronic disease, and these types of disease I want to explain. The first one is the infectious disease. Infectious disease means the disease which spread from one person to another. As you all know, nowadays you all know about the COVID-19. It is also one type of infectious disease because it spreads from one person to another when we are in physical contact. So there are many things we have to adopt nowadays to control that disease: social distancing and wearing masks and so many things. So that you all know, infectious disease means which spread from one person to another, like cholera. Cholera is also one type of infectious disease. Second one is non-infectious disease, means which do not spread from one person to another. In non-infectious disease, we can take congenital disease or deficiency disease. Congenital disease means which the disease which occurs by birth. Example is hemophilia. It is a disease which is hereditary. And it passed from the parents to their children, means it is a congenital disease. Deficiency disease means which occurs due to the lack of nutrients. Nutrients like carbohydrates, protein, fats, if we are lacking in our diet, then we suffer from deficiency disease. Like you know that vitamin A, if we are having lacking in our body, we suffer from night blindness. And night blindness means in the dim light or in the at night we are unable to see the object. In the same way, another type of deficiency disease is scurvy, which is caused due to the deficiency of vitamin C. Beriberi, like, it is also a disease which is caused due to deficiency of vitamin B in our body. So deficiency disease always occurs due to the deficiency means lack of any kind of nutrients in our body. Now there are some diseases which are caused by different microorganisms. And every microorganisms, they have the target organ in our body. Target organ means that organism only attacks that part of our body and that part is affected. So the disease which is caused by different microorganism, first I want to mention, first is the viral disease. Viral disease means which are caused due to virus. Like AIDS. AIDS is caused by HIV virus, I have already told you in the previous class. So, influenza, so many diseases are caused by virus. So they are called viral disease. Second one is bacterial disease, which are caused when bacteria enters our body. So such type of disease is called bacterial disease. So there are so many bacterial diseases Plasmodium is a type of protozoa which causes malaria, and it is carried by the female Anopheles mosquito, which carries the Plasmodium. And when the female Anopheles mosquito bite the healthy person, they can cause malaria. Next is the disease which is caused by the vectors. Means the like malaria also we can take in the vectors, because female Anopheles mosquito is the carrier of the germs which cause malaria. Or another we can take the example rabies, which is caused due to the bite of the infected dog, and so many others. And the last one is the fungal disease, which is caused by the fungi like ringworm or any kind of skin disease. Skin disease is mostly affected by the fungus. So these are the various kinds of disease or the various kinds of microorganisms which cause various types of disease. And now, how do we know that a person is suffering from disease? So we know only by their symptoms. And symptoms, if we see in the body of the infected person or the diseased person, we can know that he or she is suffering from disease. And the proper diagnosis only can be done by the doctor. So if the doctor, if any person is suffering from disease, any kind of disease, so he or she has to go to the doctor, doctors diagnose what type of disease he is suffering from by various means, by blood tests or by looking at the body of the patient or by taking the heartbeat, whatever methods he can do, he diagnose and he give proper treatment. Then only by his treatment a person can be free from disease. And if we don't want that, if we want that our body remain healthy always, and if we don't, nobody wants that he or she should affect any kind of disease. So the most important thing is that prevention is better than cure. Prevention is better than cure means if we want that our body do not suffer from any kind of disease, means we have to take precautions. Like especially the viral disease mostly is caused in the overcrowding places. So if we want that our body to be protected from any kind of disease which are caused by the, or which is affected when we go outside or in the overcrowding place, first we should avoid the overcrowding places. Second is, as I have already told you, the factors which affect the good health, proper food or balanced diet. Because proper food or balanced diet keeps the immune system strong. So if we take proper diet, then our immune system becomes strong, and because of that any kind of germs does not affect easily to our body and we will be free from the disease. Third is, we should maintain personal hygiene. As I have already told you, we should maintain proper cleanliness of our body. Community hygiene is also important. We should keep our surroundings also clean. If like we keep our house clean, our room clean, in the same way our community or the surroundings should also be kept clean, then only we will be free from any kind of disease. Besides this, there are other factors also by which we can protect our body from any kind of disease, because prevention is better than cure. And tomorrow I will explain you about the vaccination. and about the immunization. How vaccination and immunization helps to keep our body free from any kind of disease. Thank you.